Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Roger with Electronics and Gadgets. If this is your first time here, thanks for stopping by. Hit the like and subscribe, please. If you've been here before, thank you. For my next video, I would like to do one on iPhones, how to change your 5G setting for better battery life and faster speeds. 5G cellular service is expanding across all carriers and works with the iPhone 12, 13, 14, and SE3. Apple uses a 5G auto setting as the default that aims to give users a balance between network speed and battery life. But you can also manage the setting manually to optimize for what you need in a given moment. Follow along for how to turn 5G on and off on an iPhone. If you're curious about what kind of 5G performance you'll see with your iPhone, that will vary depending on where you live and your carrier. In the USA, Verizon, AT&T, and T-Mobile all have 5G available network and top speeds that can reach beyond 1,000 megabits or 1 gigabyte. However, this won't be the norm for most. But the iPhone 14 Pro and Pro Max are quite a bit faster for cellular speeds. They are also currently the fastest phones on the market. The iPhone 14 Pro has 50% faster download speeds versus the iPhone 13 Pro and the Samsung Galaxy S22. There are several types of 5G. mmWave offers the fastest speed but has a quite limited range, and sub 6G 5G, which has a better range but speeds closer to 4G LTE. And only the iPhone 12, 13, and 14 support both mmWave and sub 6G 5G service. However, one downside to 5G is it uses more battery than LTE. Some tests have shown that the iPhone lasting from 1 to 2.5 hours longer when sticking with the 4G LTE versus the 5G. The iPhone default 5G setting. The 5G is on by default with compatible iPhones, but won't be used permanently, even if available. It uses what Apple calls smart data mode that tries to automatically strike the best balance between 5G and LTE and battery life. Apple even said it takes into account your data plan. The default settings for 5G on iPhone are optimized for battery life and data usage based on your data plan. You can customize these options for when you use 5G and how much data to use in some apps. However, inside the cellular settings, you can choose to turn 5G on or off on the iPhone manually to optimize for speed or battery life. How to turn 5G on or off on the iPhone. Head to the Settings app on your iPhone. Tap Cellular. Choose Cellular Data Options. Tap Voice and Data. With 5G Auto as the default, you can choose 5G on to use it anytime it's available for faster speeds. Alternatively, if you want to turn 5G off completely, tap LTE for better battery life. You can also tap data mode in the cellular settings and pick allow more data on 5G for higher quality video and streaming for things like FaceTime. And the opposite, low data mode for when you want to conserve. Turn 5G on or off. What is this icon? With the different types of 5G service, sub 6 GHz, mmWave, etc., Apple has four different icons in the iPhone status bar to denote what you're using, no matter if you turn 5G on manually or use the 5G Auto Smart Data Mode. Verizon uses 5G UW to note mmWave and other high-frequency 5G connections. AT&T uses 5G Plus and T-Mobile labels it 5G UC, ultra capacity. If you see the plan 5G in your status bar, that's signaling you're on lower spectrum, greater range and coverage, slower speeds comparatively. I'll put a diagram explaining below. So that was my video on 5G settings for the iPhone. I hope you found my videos to be helpful. Thank you for being here. Please click like and subscribe to my channel. Leave me a comment down below, and until next time, I'm out. Thank you.